and what is officially asked the day before, and the receptor cell also won't actually convert glucose into the body, or the energy the body needs, because you can't use the glucose, you have to convert it to use. And the other big thing about diabetes, along with the fact that it has like myocardial disease, hypertension, it also causes peripheral vascular disease. So you get basically heart disease in the peripheral part of your body, and it reduces blood flow. Say you stub your toe and it bleeds, and everything has bacteria. The typical person like us, we would be able to have good blood flow and heal it out, but blood cells would be able to go down there and infect the infection. But these people, they don't have the circulation, so they get a lot of gangrene. They get a lot of amputation problems. They have to have their toes cut off, to their blood, to their feet, below the knee, amputation. And that affects your lifestyle a lot. And then the last thing I'm just going to talk about is heart disease. The American Diabetes Association, the people with actual diabetes have a higher risk of having a heart attack and stroke just because of the simple comorbidities, which means multiple diseases that can cause the same effect. And like the heart attack you see here, it's the same exact concept, just where the blood's going with block. You can have a stroke when you have clotted artery to your brain, and you have a heart attack with the same thing, clotted artery to your heart attack. So the question is, what can we do to change our lifestyles, like we said before? Like, you've seen what obesity can do to you now, it's up to us and our responsibility to change our lifestyles, especially our children's lifestyles or even our parents' lifestyles. What can we do to change it? It starts with diet. Everyone has seen the typical nutrition reaction. Everyone knows your bread, your wheat, your pasta, whole grains, the fruits, the meats, the vegetables. I don't even follow that after it. It's hard to get in that many servings of vegetables and fruit in a day. But the problem is, you know, America, our lifestyle, we're so busy, we're always working, we always rely on fast food. And that's point for that. A double quarter pounder with cheese from McDonald's. I just took out four of the biggest offenders. Fat, 42 grams of fat, and one double quarter pounder. That's 65% of your daily value of fat. 65% just one hamburger. Saturated fat, 19 grams of saturated fat, which is the worst type of fat, which leads to the worst type of cholesterol, which causes coronary artery disease, heart disease, diabetes. That's 95% of your daily value of fat. It's almost all the saturated fat you should intake based on a 2,000 calorie diet. Cholesterol, 155 milligrams, 52%. And sodium. We talk about hypertension and sodium because sodium holds water in 13.8 milligrams. That's over half your daily intake of sodium. And as you can see, like we're talking about childhood obesity, it's a problem. We have to change our lifestyle, we have to change our diet, we have to be healthier. The World Health Organization, they found good things about eating healthy food. One of them is it decreases your chance of these comorbidities, the diseases we talked about. And it improves your immune system because, you know, when you have good vegetables, fruits, they're high in antioxidants and other vitamins that improve your immune system. Gives you more energy, less stress. And another one, it helps you maintain a stable weight. A lot of people crash diet, and when they come off that crash diet, they put the weight right back on because they didn't diet properly. The next thing, that's what I was talking about, the good points of eating healthy from the World Health Organization. And we have the second most important thing, we have to have a more physical lifestyle. We're too sedentary, we work 40-hour jobs, we sit at the desk, we go home, we're tired, we don't want to do anything, we just sit down on Saturday afternoon. The second most biggest contributing risk factor is this. They found that group activity was an important modifier of mortality and morbidity, which are the diseases we talked about, related to overweight and obesity. And they have firm evidence that physical activity correlates to obesity. Obviously, if you burn calories, you lose weight. So, fitness is a battle right down on the bottom left there. It's something we have to take responsibility for. We have to own up to that. Third is to see a doctor. A medical doctor, they can check your glucose levels. If you're pre-diabetic, called metabolic syndrome. They can put you on medication that will help. They can prescribe you a workout program. They can help prescribe you a diet. Things that can stop or prevent these things in their own tracks from happening. They can check your blood pressure. They can put you on a diet also with your blood pressure, like we talked about, reduced sodium. resilient, data decentralization, social health as well. And the priorities of these things have to do communication, that's when we draw on these, which is external tests they can do to help figure out what's going on. Well, in the end, 68% of us, our population, our society, is obese, or overweight, actually. It's our responsibility. We put food into our mouths, we take care of our children. It's our job to stop this from happening. Because those three conditions, or three top ranking conditions of death in the United States of America, and it's not only in the U.S., it's all over. It's Europe, it's Asia, it's everywhere. So it's our responsibility to take care of ourselves. And he said, you have to change your diet. You have to be healthier. You have to win this food pyramid and start taking more vegetables, grains, less fast food. We have to exercise now. You know, on a Saturday afternoon, you're just sitting around doing nothing, just go for a walk. It conditions your body, it makes you healthier. It improves your lifestyle. So without change, our society is going to suffer even more. And